The global population is aging faster than ever before. By 2040, more than 1 billion people will be over the age of 65. In applied health sciences, researchers are tackling some of the most pressing aging-related issues to bridge the generation gap and develop better care practices.
In Canada, older adults are increasing in number. We know that these older adults are not eating the nutrition they need to be healthy and have a good quality of life. My name is Heather Keller. I do nutrition research in long-term care.
Dementia is the second most feared disease in Canada after cancer. By 2031, more than 1.4 million Canadians will have an illness causing dementia. My name is Sherry Dupuy, and I'm working hard to change the way we think about dementia and dementia care in Canada.
Aging begins the moment we are born. We have long thought that factors in childhood may set the stage for better brain function in late life, but we don't know why. My name is Suzanne Tyus, and I study cognitive resilience across the life course.
I'm researching how novel foods that have more nutrition can help older adults to be as well as they can in long-term care. By improving the nutrition in terms of micronutrients, vitamins, and minerals that older adults consume, we're hoping this will help to improve their health, improve their function, and of course, improve their quality of life.
I'm working to change dementia care in a number of ways, but one of the most powerful ways I'm using is theater as a way to expose the assumptions and misunderstandings that we have about people with dementia and absurdities that we have in practice. So we can actually help people to reflect on those assumptions and practices and change them.
We don't have any way to cure Alzheimer's disease. And so research that provides clues to prevent Alzheimer's disease is key. Building cognitive resilience is a strategy to prevent Alzheimer's disease and increase the chance of healthy aging for all.